Ancient Hebrew scriptures foretold of the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach. The Messiah Yeshua came to call the people back to the truth of His Word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
Let's go get a blessing. Turn to the Gospel of Yohanan, John chapter 8, please.
Vamos a ir al Evangelio de Juan, capítulo 8, por favor.
Yohanan, John chapter 8, please.
Juan, capítulo 8, por favor.
This message is called Three Things I Pray.
Este mensaje es llamado Tres Cosas Que Oro.
It is 277th taped message.
Este es grabado 277.
We're going to learn about three things about God today.
Vamos a aprender tres cosas de Dios hoy día.
We're going to learn how to draw closer to Him today.
Vamos a aprender cómo acercarnos más a Él hoy en día.
We're going to learn how important your translation is.
Y qué importante es la traducción.
How important it is to understand Messiah from the proper perspective.
Qué importante es entender el Mesías de la vista apropiada.
To understand Him as a Jew.
Conocerlo como un judío.
Because Messiah came unto His own, right?
Porque el Mesías vino a sus propios.
So when you become part of His family,
cuando te conviertes parte de su familia,
you need to understand who He is better.
Tienes que aprender quién es el mejor.
You need to learn how to speak His language.
Tienes que saber cómo hablar su lenguaje.
Because in heaven, we are going to be speaking Hebrew.
Porque en el cielo vamos a hablar hebreo.
Most likely with a Spanish accent.
Puede ser un acento hispano.
Because why do I say that we're going to be speaking Hebrew in heaven?
¿Por qué estoy diciendo que vamos a estar hablando hebreo en el cielo?
Because of that, the Torah.
Por esto, la Torah.
Because God gave us His perfect word in the Hebrew language.
Porque Dios nos dio su escritura, su palabra en el lenguaje perfecto que es hebreo.
John chapter 8, we're going to look at verse 34 through 47.
Juan capítulo 8, vamos a ver versículos 34 hasta el 47.
Yeshua answered them, "Yes, indeed, I tell you that everyone who practices sin is a slave to sin. Now, a slave does not remain with a family forever, but a son does remain with it forever. So if the son frees you, you will really be free. I know you are the seed of Abraham, yet you are out to kill me, because what I am saying makes no headway in you. I say what my father has shown me, you do what your father has told you." They answered him, "Our father is Abraham." Yeshua replied, "If you are children of Abraham, then do the things Abraham did. As it is, you are out to kill me, a man who told you the truth, which I heard from God. Abraham did nothing like that. You are doing the things your father does. We're not illegitimate children," they said to him. "We have only one father, God." Yeshua replied to them, "If God were your father, you would love me because I came out from God, and now I have arrived here. I did not come out on my own. He sent me. Why don't you understand what I'm saying? Because you can't bear to listen to my message. You belong to your father, Satan, and you want to carry out your father's desires. From the start, he was a murderer, and he has never stood by the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he tells a lie, he is speaking in character, because he is a liar indeed, the inventor of the lie. But as for me, because I tell you the truth, you don't believe me. Which one of you can show me where I'm wrong? If I'm telling you the truth, why don't you believe me? Whoever belongs to God listens to what God says. The reason you don't listen is that you don't belong to God. Amen?
Amen.
Let's look closer at verse 34 and 35.
Vamos a mirar cercamente versículos 34 y 35.
Yeshua answered them, "Yes, indeed, I tell you that everyone who practices sin is a slave to sin. Now a slave does not remain with a family forever, but a son does remain with it forever." Amen?
Amen.
What would it be to be a slave to sin?
¿Qué sería ser un esclavo al pecado?
Well, first we must ask, what is sin?
Primero tenemos que preguntar qué es el pecado.
Not in my eyes.
No en los ojos míos.
Not in Juan's eyes.
No en los ojos de Juan.
Not in Jessica's eyes.
No en mis ojos, Jessica.
We must ask what sin is to Adonai.
Pero tenemos que preguntar qué es el pecado en los ojos de Adonai.
So that we would not be a slave to that anymore.
Para que nosotros no seamos esclavos a eso ya.
If you are a new creation in Adonai,
si eres una nueva creación en Adonai,
then you should put away those things that are not of Adonai.
Entonces debes de guardar esas cosas que no son de Adonai.
You should stop practicing the sin of the world.
Debes de parar de practicar el pecado del mundo.
You know, a long time ago, I used to be a big drinker.
Mucho tiempo atrás, yo era un bebedor muy fuerte.
At my bachelor party.
En mi fiesta de soltero.
My tolerance for alcohol was so high.
Mi tolerancia para el alcohol era tan alto.
Because I was in bars 5-6 nights a week.
Porque 5 o 6 noches a la semana yo estaba en las barras.
Because I did sound for a living.
Porque hice sonido por la vida.
So the sound guys used to drink for free.
Esos que hacían el sonido bebían gratis.
At my bachelor party.
En mi fiesta de soltero.
I had 15 double shots of Sambuca.
Bebí 15 bebidas de Sambuca.
I had a half a dozen Alabama Slammers.
Tenía más de una docena de Alabama Slammers.
Which has 7 alcohols in it.
Que tiene 7 tipos de alcohol adentro.
I had a half a dozen beers.
Bebí no sé cuántas cervezas.
And I was still standing.
Y todavía estaba parado.
But when I became a believer in
Pero
Messiah,
cuando me hice un creyente en el Mesías,
and I began to read His Word,
y empecé de leer su palabra,
I saw what Noah did.
Yo vi lo que hizo Noé.
And his sin caused another to sin.
Y su pecado causó que otro pecado.
And then his son made fun of him because he was naked.
Su hijo se burló de él porque estaba desnudo.
Because he was drunk.
Porque estaba borracho.
Maybe if he wasn't drunk,
si no estaba borracho,
maybe his son would not have sinned.
Puede ser que su hijo no iba a pecar.
So I learned that was not good to drink to get drunk.
Entonces yo aprendí que no era bueno beber para estar borracho.
So here where Messiah is talking about being a slave to sin,
aquí cuando el Mesías está hablando de ser un esclavo al pecado,
I decided that was not good for me anymore.
Yo decidí que esto no era bueno para mí.
And I put that away from out of my life.
Y yo saqué eso de mi vida.
But it wasn't at first.
Pero no en el principio.
It took a little while.
Tomó un poquito de tiempo.
The more I read Adonai's word,
más que leí la palabra de Adonai,
the more I wanted to be like my Messiah,
más quería ser como mi Mesías.
I never see Messiah getting drunk.
Yo nunca veo al Mesías emborrachándose.
But he's missing such a party.
Pero él está faltando una fiesta.
I don't see Messiah getting drunk.
No veo al Mesías emborrachándose.
He's missing such a party.
Pero él está faltando en esa party, fiesta.
I don't see Messiah getting drunk.
Yo no veo al Mesías emborrachándose.
He's not missing a party at all.
Él no está faltando en la fiesta.
So I put that sin out of my life.
Entonces yo saqué ese pecado de mi vida.
Because as I learned the word of Adonai,
porque cuando aprendí la palabra de Adonai,
I wanted more of him in my life.
Yo quería más de él en mi vida.
And less of me in my own life.
Y menos de yo en mi vida.
I wanted to mirror him.
Quería estar su imagen, tener un espejo de su imagen en mi vida.
I didn't want to listen to the lies of Satan anymore.
No quería escuchar las mentiras de Satanás ya.
Oh, that Yeshua, he's just a stick in the mud, Satan says.
Oh, ese Yeshua sí es de sabrío, dice
He doesn't
Satanás.
Have any fun at all.
Él no se divierte.
We got a party with the party people.
Tenemos que hacer fiesta con la gente que hace fiestas.
And at first I said, you're right, Satan.
Y en el principio le dije, oh, es verdad, Satanás.
Yeshua is, he is no fun.
Yeshua no es divertido.
But as I began to read the word of Adonai,
pero cuando empecé a leer la palabra de Adonai,
I realized that Satan was lying to me.
Realicé que Satanás estaba mintiéndome a mí.
In the most joyous times I've ever had in my life.
Y que los tiempos más gozosos que he tenido en mi vida.
Has been the times I've been alone with Adonai.
Son esos tiempos que he estado solo con Adonai.
Has been the times when, like just before, how we worshiped Adonai.
Son esos tiempos como antes que nosotros estábamos adorando a Adonai.
When a cheer went up because he was glorified.
Cuando un grito de jubilación salió arriba cuando él estaba glorificado.
This is joy to me.
Esta es la jubilación para
so
mí.
So I told Satan.
So yo le dije a Satanás.
Go back to hell where you came from.
Váyase al infierno donde viniste.
Because you're a liar.
Porque tú eres un mentiroso.
Go back to your house.
Vete para atrás a tu casa.
Because I don't want to listen to you anymore.
Porque no quiero escucharte ya.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's look closer at verse 43 and 44.
Vamos a mirar cercamente versículos 43 y 44.
Why don't you understand what I'm saying? Because you can't bear to listen to my message. You belong to your father Satan, and you want to carry out your father's desires. From the start, he was a murderer, and he has never stood by the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he tells a lie, he is speaking in character, because he is a liar indeed, the inventor of the lie. Amen?
Amen.
Our enemy, Satan,
nuestro enemigo, Satanás,
will do anything to anyone to get you to follow him.
Va a hacer lo que él quiera a quien quiera para ser lo que lo sigue a él.
He will mix up the truth.
Él va a mezclar la verdad.
He will turn a phrase just a little bit to make you believe him.
Él cambiará una frase para hacerte que tú lo crees.
Oh, look at them. They're looking at you.
Oh, míralo. Ellos están mirando.
Is there something on my shirt?
¿Hay algo en mi camisa?
Yeah. You ever get there? People are you know they're talking about you.
¿Tú has tenido ese sentimiento que alguien está hablando de ti?
And, you know, Satan's whispering in your ear.
Y Satanás está murmurando en el oído.
Oh, they're talking about you now again.
Oh, ellos están hablando de ti otra vez.
Oh, you think you're so holy.
Oh, tú crees que tú eres tan santo.
Oh, you won't go party with us.
Oh, tú no quieres festejar conmigo.
See, the enemy of Adonai.
El enemigo de Adonai.
He will turn a phrase on you.
Él va a cambiar una frase tuya.
So that you will start doubting the king.
Para que tú dudes al rey.
And so the message from Elyon will not make sense to you.
Y el mensaje del más alto no va a hacer sentido a ti.
That's why we are in the Acharit Hayamim, the end of days.
Por eso que estamos en los días finales.
And we need to focus on the truth of the Scripture.
Y por eso tenemos que enfocarnos en la verdad de las Escrituras.
We need to look at Yeshua himself and follow his example.
Tenemos que mirar a Yeshua él mismo y seguir su ejemplo.
We need to read our Bibles more.
Tenemos que leer nuestras Escrituras, nuestras Biblias más.
How many people read 20 chapters in the Bible this week?
¿Cuántas personas han leído 20 capítulos esta semana en la Biblia?
How many people read 15 chapters in the Bible?
¿Cuántas personas 15 capítulos en la Biblia?
How many people read 10?
10.
How many people didn't read this week?
¿Quién no leyó esta semana?
It's not good.
No es bueno.
Did you eat this week?
¿Comiste esta semana?
Did everybody breathe today?
¿Todo el mundo respiró hoy?
Did everybody breathe more than 20 times today?
¿Una persona ha respirado más de 20 veces hoy día?
So this Bible, which is ours.
Entonces esta Biblia que es de nosotros.
This should be life and breath to us.
Esto debe ser vida y respirar para nosotros.
This is what we should open up our day with.
Es esto que debemos de abrir nuestro día
and
con
this
esto.
Is what we should end our day with.
Y cómo nosotros vamos a concluir nuestro día.
So that we could see the lies of Satan.
Para ver las mentiras de Satanás.
And we need to be sure when we are reading our Bible.
Y tenemos que estar seguro cuando estamos leyendo nuestras Biblias.
We need to have a good understanding of our Bible.
Un entendimiento bueno de nuestras Biblias.
And we need to have a proper translation of our Bible.
Y una traducción apropiada de nuestras Biblias.
Because there's a lot of translations out there now.
Porque hay muchas traducciones allá afuera.
There's one translation.
Hay una traducción.
Called the Gender Non-Specific Bible.
Que está llamando el no específico.
No específico.
Sexo.
Whatever. Sexo, sí.
Yes. Okay.
It says he, she said.
Dice él, ella dijo.
It doesn't say he said.
No dice él dijo.
It says he, she said.
Dice él, ella dijo.
Take that Bible and burn it.
Coge esa Biblia y lo quemas.
Because it is not a Bible.
Porque no es una Biblia.
This word of Adonai is perfect.
Esta palabra de Adonai es perfecta.
And when it says he, it means he.
Y cuando dice él, significa él.
When it says she, it means she.
Cuando dice ella, significa ella.
And God is a he.
Y Dios es
Sorry,
un él.
Ladies.
Perdona, mujeres.
He came to earth as a man.
Él vino a la tierra como un hombre.
He didn't come to earth as a transgender, bender, gendered, cross-dressing, froofy person. He came as a guy.
No vino como un hombre que se viste como mujer. Vino como un hombre.
So you got to make sure the Bible you are reading.
Tienes que estar segura que la Biblia que estás leyendo.
That the translation is good.
Que la traducción está buena.
Did some of these newer translations?
Algunas de las nuevas traducciones.
Oh, you know, this made it a little more modern sounding.
Oh, esto lo hace ser sonar más moderno.
Oh, we don't talk like that anymore.
Oh, nosotros no hablamos así
ya. But did they just copy the same errors that were made before?
Pero copiaron los mismos errores que estaban haciéndolo en pasado.
See, this is where Satan does his best work.
Es aquí donde Satanás hace su mejor trabajo.
The changing sometimes of one word.
Cambiando una palabra.
Can change the whole context of the sentence.
Puede cambiar el contexto de la oración completa.
See, my Spanish is getting better.
Mi español se está mejorando.
But sometimes I misunderstand things.
Pero a veces malentiendo las cosas.
Because I miss the verb.
Porque no tengo el verbo.
I'm good with the nouns.
Soy bueno con el sustantivo.
But I am terrible with the verbs.
Pero soy terrible con los verbos.
And sometimes I'm even worse with the tenses.
Y peor con los tensos.
So,
¿cómo? Oraciones.
Like her.
Como yo.
And I misunderstand things sometimes.
Y malentiendo las cosas a veces.
But when we are reading our Bibles,
pero cuando estamos leyendo nuestras Biblias,
we want to make sure we understand every single word.
Queremos estar seguros que estamos entendiendo cada palabra.
See, the adversary, Satan, knows all the details of the Bible.
Satanás, él sabe todos los detalles de la Biblia.
And he will make you think that you don't need the whole Bible.
Y él te va a hacer creer que tú no necesitas la Biblia completa.
But we need the whole Bible.
Pero necesitamos la Biblia completa.
So that we can understand God in his fullness.
Para que podamos entender Dios completamente.
Let's look at verse 46 and 47 again, please.
El 46 y 47 versículos, por favor.
Which one of you can show me where I'm wrong? If I'm telling you the truth, why don't you believe me? Whoever belongs to God listens to what God says. The reason you don't listen is that you don't belong to God. Amen?
Amen.
The religious leaders in the time of Messiah,
los que estaban, que eran líderes religiosos en los tiempos del Mesías,
most of them didn't have a passion for their job.
Muchos de ellos no tenían pasión por sus trabajos.
To do this job of the rabbi,
para hacer este trabajo como el rabino,
you must have a passion for Adonai.
Tienes que tener una pasión para Adonai.
Because you generally make a lot of people angry.
Porque generalmente vas a enojar muchas personas.
The pay stinks.
El sueldo no es bueno.
So to do this job,
so para hacer este trabajo,
you must want to love Adonai.
Tienes que querer a Adonai.
Because sometimes you have to talk to people.
Porque a veces tiene que hablar con algunas personas.
And sometimes people are in sin.
Y algunas personas están en pecado.
And you have to tell them that they're in sin.
Y le tienes que decir que están en pecado.
Generally, this is not an easy task.
Generalmente no es un trabajo muy fácil.
Sometimes people don't want to hear the truth.
A veces las personas no quieren escuchar la verdad.
And they fight hearing the truth.
Y ellos... Would you fight?
They fight.
Y ellos pelean de oír la verdad.
And they get angry at you.
Y se enojan contigo.
And this is what was going on in Israel in the time of Messiah.
Y esto es lo que estaba sucediendo en el tiempo del Mesías.
The rabbis were more wanting to please people.
Los rabinos querían complacer a las personas.
And to please man.
Complacer el hombre.
Than to please God.
En vez de a Dios.
So when Messiah says to them.
Cuando el Mesías le dice a ellos.
That you don't belong to God.
Que tú no pertenece a Dios.
Because they were not having passion for his word.
Porque no tenían pasión por su palabra.
They were not teaching his word.
No estaban enseñando su palabra.
They were not following his word.
No estaban siguiendo su palabra.
We need to walk like Yeshua.
Nosotros tenemos que caminar como Yeshua.
We don't need to walk like those Pharisees.
No como los fariseos.
We want to be drawn closer into His footsteps.
Queremos acercarnos más a sus pisadas.
That's why this shouldn't just be coming to Shabbat.
Por eso es que no, esto no debe nada más ser viniendo a Shabbat.
Oh, we're coming to the temple on Saturday.
Oh, estamos yendo al templo el sábado.
Oh, I'm going to go see my friends.
Oh, voy a ver mis amistades.
This should be life to you.
Esto debe ser vida
this
para
is,
ti.
Should be the day that you get your batteries recharged.
Debe ser el día que tú recargas tu batería.
So the other 6 days of the week that when you're out there,
para que los otros 6 días a la semana que estás allá afuera,
getting beat up by the world,
siendo golpeado del mundo,
I'm going to get a chain for this thing.
Yo voy a buscar una cadena.
I fixed it.
Lo arreglé, pero not really.
I'm going to put some Gorilla Glue on it next time. Somebody out there has got to come up with some good Tali clips.
Alguien tiene que buscar
from Home
unos
Depot.
De Home Depot.
Yes, I'm a biker rabbi, dude. Okay. Now where was I? Sorry,
¿dónde
Lord.
Está? Perdona, señor.
Could you please fix this?
Por favor, arregla esto.
So when you come to Shabbat,
cuando vienes a Shabbat,
it should be that you desire to be in Adonai's presence.
Debe de ser que tú deseas estar en la presencia de Adonai.
So that when you're out there at your jobs,
para que cuando estés allá en tu trabajo,
at my secular job,
bueno, mi trabajo secular,
there's this 30, young 30-something woman who
hay una mujer que es joven,
sits next to me in another cube.
Que se sienta al lado de mí en otro cúbico.
And the other day,
y el otro día,
I heard so much profanity coming out of this girl's mouth.
Yo oí tanta profanidad viniendo de la boca de esta muchacha.
I almost took my head around the cube.
Por poco tomé mi cabeza alrededor del cúbico.
I wanted to say, do you understand that you are in a cube and everybody can hear you?
¿Tú no estás entendiendo que estás en un cúbico y todo el mundo te puede oír?
So when I come to Shabbat,
entonces cuando vengo a Shabbat,
you want to get recharged.
Quieres ser recargado.
So you don't go and do that your flesh wants to do.
Para que no vas a hacer las para que no hagas las cosas que la carne quiere hacer.
Do you understand that I can hear every word you're saying?
¿Tú estás entendiendo que puedo oír cada palabra que estás diciendo?
So you should want to come to this day.
Tienes que querer venir a este día.
So that you can make the rest of your journey proper.
Para que puedas hacer el resto de tu jornada apropiadamente.
So that we can understand when Adonai is talking to us.
Para que nosotros podemos entender cuando Adonai nos está hablando.
So when you're thinking about choking your office mate,
entonces cuando estén pensando a ahorcar tu compañero de trabajo,
you can hear the Holy Spirit, the Ruach, saying to you,
tú puedes oír el Espíritu Santo diciéndote en el oído,
that murder is a sin.
El asesinato es un pecado.
This would not shine the Father's light.
No, esto no es alumbrar la luz del Padre.
But it would be fun for a moment.
Puede ser divertido por un momento.
But jail is not good, he says.
Pero la cárcel no es bueno, él dice.
So you have to learn how to listen to the Spirit.
Entonces tienes que aprender cómo escuchar el Espíritu.
And to not be like the religious leaders in Messiah's time.
Y no ser como los líderes religiosos en el tiempo del Mesías.
Oh, they had beautiful talits.
Oh, ya tenían talits tan bello.
They had wonderful garments.
Muchas vestiduras bellas.
And they had phylacteries that were beautiful.
Y tenían phylacterios. Muy bueno.
But they did not see their own Messiah.
Pero ellos no vieron su propio Mesías.
You need to come close to Adonai.
Tú tienes que acercarte de Adonai.
To learn His word.
Aprender su
to
palabra.
Follow in His footsteps.
Seguir sus pisadas.
Look at 46 and 47 again,
vamos
please.
Vamos a mirar 46 y 47 otra vez, por favor.
Which one of you can show me where I'm wrong? If I'm telling you the truth, why don't you believe me? Whoever belongs to God listens to what God says. The reason you don't listen is that you don't belong to God. Amen?
Amen.
The religious leaders could not say the reason they were angry with Yeshua.
Los líderes religiosos no podían dar una razón por qué estaban enojados con Yeshua.
They just didn't like him messing with their job.
Ellos no les gustaban que él estaba haciendo su trabajo.
You ever do that to some of your colleagues?
¿Tú has hecho eso con algunos de tus colegas?
You're just trying to help them do their job better.
Están tratando de ayudar.
And they're like, you're trying to steal my job?
Y están diciendo, tú estás tratando de robar mi trabajo. ¿Tú quieres mi trabajo?
Dude, I'm just trying to help.
Yo nada más
I got a real
ayudar.
Job outside of here.
Yo tengo un trabajo real afuera de aquí.
I I preach the word of God.
Yo predico la palabra de
I'm
Dios.
I'm just trying to help you.
Yo nada más estoy tratando de ayudarte.
But this is what the religious leaders were against Messiah.
Pero es esto que están haciendo los líderes religiosos en contra del Mesías.
That's why they fell into Satan's trap.
Por eso es que cayeron en la trampa de Satanás.
Had they thought about what Messiah was saying,
si ellos pensarían en lo que estaba diciendo el Mesías,
then they would have realized that he was just trying to help them.
Entonces iban a realizar que él nada más lo estaba tratando de ayudar.
But then they fell into a terrible trap.
Pero se cayeron en una trampa muy horrible.
A trap that got us kicked out of our house for 2,000 years.
Una trampa que nos expulsó de nuestra casa por 2,000 años.
Because of terrible lack of judgment.
Por una falta de juicio apropiado.
Anybody make a bad decision this week?
¿Alguien ha hecho una decisión mala esta semana?
You know, there's traffic ahead. And
hay un tráfico allá.
And you made a left.
Hiciste una izquierda.
And then you got lost.
Entonces te perdiste.
Or something like that.
Algo así.
Did anybody make a bad decision?
¿Alguien hizo una decisión mala?
We want to learn today how to make good decisions.
Queremos aprender hoy cómo hacer decisiones buenas.
So that you don't waste time in your lives.
Para que no pierdas tiempo en tu vida.
We need to hold on to what is valuable.
Tenemos que agarrarnos de las cosas que son valorosas.
I heard somebody say this phrase this week.
Yo oí a alguien decir esta frase hoy, esta semana.
You're only holding on to something valuable.
Tú nada más estás agarrando algo valioso.
As long as somebody wants it.
En el tiempo que alguien lo quiere.
I'm holding on to gold.
Yo estoy agarrándome del oro.
I have gold in my hand.
Yo tengo oro en mi mano.
I have the keys to the kingdom in my hand.
Tengo las llaves al reino en mi manos.
But if nobody wants it,
pero si nadie lo quiere,
then it wouldn't be gold.
Entonces no va a ser oro.
So we are holding gold in our hands.
Entonces nosotros estamos agarrando el oro en nuestras manos.
If we understand his words.
Si entendemos su palabra.
See, people today are the same way they were 2,000 years ago.
¿Ves? Las personas hoy en día son lo mismo que hace 2,000 años atrás.
People are still seekers of money.
La gente todavía están buscando el dinero.
Seekers of power.
Buscando el poder.
Seekers of the flesh.
Buscando cosas de la carne.
Everything back then was the same as it is today.
Todo en esos tiempos es lo mismo que hoy en día.
But where we have surpassed them,
pero donde nosotros hemos sobrepasado ellos,
is our love of Adonai's word has gotten colder.
Es que nuestro amor por la palabra de Adonai se ha enfriado.
When the love of Adonai's word got colder back then,
cuando el amor de la palabra de Adonai se enfrió en esos tiempos,
he had to kick them out of his house for 2,000 years.
Él tuvo que expulsarlo por 2,000 años.
Because people did not have passion for his word.
Porque las personas no tenían pasión por su palabra.
We need to have passion for his word.
Tenemos que tener pasión por su palabra.
Yesterday morning,
ayer en la mañana,
the Lord woke me up at 5:44 in the morning.
El Señor me despertó a 5:44 en la mañana.
And in this dream,
en ese sueño,
I was in this lunchroom.
Yo estaba en un cuarto de almuerzo.
No, where you're moving your tray down the line.
Donde estás moviendo su bandeja.
And then I heard there was this woman with black hair, like two people ahead of me.
Y yo oí esta mujer con pelo negro, dos personas delante de mí.
And she says, "Do you hear that song?"
Y ella me dijo, "¿Tú oyes esa canción?"
It's like, "What?"
Yo digo, "¿Qué?"
She goes, "Go over and turn up the song."
Ella dice, "Ve y sube el volumen a esa canción."
And as I turned up the radio,
y cuando estaba subiendo el volumen en el
in
radio,
the dream,
en el sueño,
I heard this song.
Yo oí esta canción.
From the musical Godspell.
De el musical Godspell.
And it goes like this.
Y va así.
Day by day.
Día por día.
Day by day.
Día por día.
Oh dear Lord.
Oh Señor querido.
Three things I pray.
Tres cosas oro.
To see thee more clearly.
Para verte más claramente.
Love thee more dearly.
Quererte más cariñosamente.
Follow thee more nearly.
Seguirte más cercamente.
Day by day.
Día por día.
And I heard the Lord calling us.
Y yo oí al Señor llamándonos a nosotros.
To follow him.
Para seguirlo a él.
Closer, day by day.
Cercamente, día por día.
It was very sad what Franklin Graham said this week.
Es muy triste lo que Franklin Graham dijo esta semana.
He said about the National Day of Prayer.
Él dijo del Día Nacional de Oración.
That he could see in his lifetime.
Que él pudo ver en su vida.
That Christians will be unable to pray in public.
Que los cristianos no van a poder orar en público.
And this saddened my spirit.
Y esto me entristeció mi espíritu.
The next thing that I thought.
La próxima cosa que pensé.
Is how can we change this sinking ship?
Es cómo es que nosotros podemos cambiar ese barco que se está hundiendo.
How could those of us who are called by his name?
¿Cómo es que nosotros que estamos llamados por su nombre?
How can we work together to plug up the hole in this sinking ship?
¿Cómo es que nosotros podemos trabajar junto para cerrar ese hoyo en ese barco que está hundiéndose?
How could we fix it from sinking?
¿Cómo podemos arreglarlo para que no se hundan?
To see more clearly.
Para ver más claramente.
To love more dearly.
Para amar más queridamente.
To follow him more nearly.
Y para seguirlo más cercamente.
Day by day.
Día por día.
See, we need to see the Lord for who he is.
Tenemos que ver al Señor por quien él es.
We need to become more like him.
Tenemos que convertirnos más como él.
We need to understand the Old Testament for the beautiful thing that it is.
Entender el Antiguo Testamento como la cosa bella que es.
We need to use this as a foundation of our lives.
Tenemos que usar esto como la fundación de nuestras vidas.
See, anybody who says that we don't need the Old Testament.
Alguien que dice que no necesitamos el Antiguo Testamento.
Then you are listening to the father of lies.
Entonces estás escuchando al padre de las mentiras.
If Adonai said it and it was written.
Si Adonai lo dijo y estaba escrito.
Then it is perfect.
Entonces es perfecto.
And we need to follow them.
Y tenemos que seguirlo.
Because we need to understand the Tanakh, the Old Testament.
Porque tenemos que entender el Antiguo Testamento.
So that we will have a solid foundation.
Para tener una fundación sólida.
When we look in and read the Brit Hadashah, the New Testament.
Cuando nosotros vemos y leer el Nuevo Testamento.
How are we going to see him more clearly?
¿Cómo lo vamos a ver más claramente?
To love him more dearly.
Amarlo más queridamente.
To follow him more nearly.
Seguirlo más cercamente.
If we do not know the foundation.
Si nosotros no conocemos la fundación.
And to follow and be with that foundation.
Y seguir y estar con esa fundación.
We must become a Jew in spirit.
Tenemos que ser un judío en espíritu.
We need to draw closer to him.
Tenemos que acercarnos más allá a él.
Because the word Jew means one who praises God.
Porque judío significa uno que alaba.
So how many Jews
Dios
do I have here?
¿Cuántos judíos tenemos aquí?
We need to praise him.
Tenemos que adorarlo.
In spirit and in truth.
En espíritu y verdad.
We need to be Jewish in our heart.
Tenemos que ser judío en nuestro corazón.
To understand his word from the original language.
Entender su palabra del lenguaje original.
This past week I bought a Septuagint.
Esta semana yo compré un
Septuagint. Septuagint.
Septuagint.
Greek.
Okay, we'll go with that.
Okay. It was the Hebrew scriptures translated into Greek.
La escritura hebrea traducida en griego.
700 years before Messiah came to earth as a man.
700 años antes que vino Mesías como un hombre a la tierra.
And this one was then translated into English.
Y esto entonces fue traducido en inglés.
I like to collect Bibles.
A mí me gusta colectar las Biblias.
I like to have the oldest things I can possibly have.
Me gusta tener las cosas más antiguas que puedo tener.
But the original New Testament.
Pero el Testamento Nuevo original.
The Gospels.
Los Evangelios.
Were written in Hebrew.
Estaban escritos en hebreo.
It's quoted by Eusebius.
Está citado por Eusebius.
In ECCL 3-39.
ECCL 3:39.
It says Matthew put together the oracles of the Lord in the Hebrew language.
Dijo que Mateo puso los oracales del Señor en el lenguaje hebreo.
And we understand this.
Y nosotros entendemos esto.
Because in hundreds of sentence structures.
Porque en muchas estructuras de oraciones.
The Greek sentence structure does not work.
La estructura griega de oraciones no trabaja.
So we have to understand that the Gospels were written in Hebrew first.
Tenemos que entender que primero los evangelios fueron escritos en hebreo.
See, in Yeshua's teachings in the book of Matthew.
En las enseñanzas de Yeshua en el libro de Mateo.
They contain significant number of Hebrew puns, alterations and word connections.
Tiene muchas oraciones que están en hebreo de la manera que hablan dicen oraciones en hebreo.
So most of the things, all Matthew, Mark, and John.
Mateo, Marcos, y Juan.
Were written in Hebrew.
Estaban escrito en hebreo.
Luke was put as a person to go see what would happen, so he wrote in Greek.
Lucas estaba una persona que estaba para decir lo que estaba sucediendo en esos tiempos y creen que está escrito en griego.
So it's vitally important for us.
Entonces es importante para nosotros.
To understand certain things from a Hebrew understanding.
Para entender las cosas de un entendimiento hebreo.
So that Satan doesn't mess you up.
Para que Satanás no juegue contigo.
Now let's take a look at one of those references.
Vamos a mirar una de esas referencias.
Turn to the Gospel of John, Yochanan.
Evangelio de Juan,
chapter 14,
capítulo
please.
14, por favor.
We're going to look at a very specific word.
Vamos a mirar una palabra específica.
And I think after this,
y después de esto,
you will draw closer to Messiah.
Te vas a acercar hacia el Mesías.
You may understand him more.
Lo vas a entender más.
John chapter 14,
Juan capítulo 14,
verse 23 through 27.
Versículos 23 al 27.
Yeshua answered him, "If someone loves me, he will keep my word. And my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him. Someone who doesn't love me doesn't keep my words, and the word you are hearing is not my own, but that of the Father who sent me. I have told you these things while I am still with you. But the Counselor, the Ruach HaKodesh, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything. That is, He will remind you of everything I have said to you. What I am leaving with you is shalom. I am giving you my shalom. I don't give the way the world gives. Don't let yourselves be upset or frightened." Amen?
Amen.
Let's look closer at verse 27.
Vamos a mirar cercamente el versículo 27.
What I am leaving with you is shalom. I am giving you my shalom. I don't give the way the world gives. Don't let yourselves be upset or frightened. Amen?
Amen.
Now, many of the translations in English,
muchas de las traducciones en inglés,
or in Spanish,
o en español,
they are not very Jewish at all.
No son muy judíos.
Well, first of all, they never use his real name.
Ellos primeramente no usan su nombre verdadero.
They call him Jesus.
Lo llaman Jesús.
I've seen many a pastor say, "And Jesus came and told me this."
Yo he visto muchos pastores decir, "Jesús me vino y me dijo esto."
That's pretty good.
Thanks. Try.
So when you see his name is Yeshua,
cuando ves que su nombre es Yeshua,
you know that he is salvation.
Tú sabes que su nombre significa salvación.
So in the translators of the King James Version,
en las traducciones de el del reino el rey King. Rey Santiago, right? James.
Just say King James.
King James.
You know, I would seriously doubt the translators of the King James Bible.
Yo seriamente dudo que los traductores de esta Biblia.
They were keeping the Shabbat.
Estaban manteniendo el Shabbat.
So, their translation might be slightly off.
Su traducción puede ser que no esté correcta.
I would seriously doubt those translators.
Yo seriamente dudo que esos eso que traducen.
Kept any of the holy days.
Estaban manteniendo los días santos.
So when they were translating Adonai's word.
So entonces cuando estaban traduciendo la palabra de Adonai.
They only had a minimal understanding of its roots.
Ellos nada más tenían un entendimiento mínimo de su raíz.
And of God the Father.
Y de Dios el Padre.
And that translation, that translated into their work.
Y esa traducción se estaba, no, evidente en su trabajo.
So now, some people try to explain cars to me.
Muchas personas me tratan de explicar los carros a mí.
I know how to drive a car.
Yo sé manejar un carro.
I know how to look at an engine.
Yo sé mirar a un motor.
Something's wrong.
Algo está incorrecto aquí.
Sometimes people try to explain cars to me.
A veces las personas me tratan de explicar los carros a mí.
This is not very good.
Esto no es muy bueno.
Because it just doesn't, it's not my thing.
Porque no es mi cosa.
Well, you know, I could talk about cars.
Yo puedo hablar sobre los carros.
My new car drives really nice.
Mi carro nuevo maneja muy bien.
But I'm not going to be able to talk about cars like some people are into cars.
Pero no voy a poder hablar de los carros como algunas personas que están interesados en esto.
But when it comes to the scriptures of my father.
Pero cuando viene a las escrituras de mi padre.
The scriptures of my people.
Las escrituras de mi pueblo.
I could talk for hours.
Yo puedo hablar por horas de esto.
Because they are life to me.
Porque son vida para mí.
But the scriptures that were translated by the King James people.
Pero las escrituras que estaban traducidas por la gente de King James.
Did they have sort of an agenda when they were translating?
Ellos tenían como una agenda cuando estaban traduciendo.
Let's look at verse 27 again.
Vamos a mirar versículo 27 otra vez.
I'm gonna actually read it in the King James.
Y lo voy a leer como lo dice en el King James.
Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Okay? Now I'm going to read it in the complete Jewish Bible.
Ahora lo voy a leer en la Biblia completa judía.
And this was translated by a Jewish guy.
Y esto fue traducido por un hombre judío.
What I am leaving with you is shalom. I am giving you my shalom. I don't give the way the world gives. Don't let yourselves be upset or frightened. Amen?
Amen.
So basically, it's similar.
Básicamente es similar.
But with a minor adjustment.
Pero con una alteración muy pequeña.
But this minor adjustment.
Pero esta alteración
is a major adjustment.
Es algo muy grande.
Because they changed the word shalom for peace.
Porque cambiaron la palabra shalom por paz.
Now the word shalom is a major part of the understanding.
La palabra shalom es una parte mayor del entendimiento.
But unless you understand the Hebrew,
pero si no entiendes el hebreo,
and what shalom means,
y qué significa la palabra shalom,
now the word shalom means completeness.
La palabra shalom significa completo.
Soundness.
It's completo, entero, yes, en firmeza, yeah.
Welfare.
Bienestar.
Peace.
Paz.
Safety.
Seguridad.
Health.
Salud.
Prosperity.
Prosperidad.
Quiet.
Callado.
Tranquility.
Tranquilidad.
Contentment.
Contento.
Friendship.
Amistad.
With God, a covenant relationship.
Con Dios, una relación de pacto.
So when Yeshua said, "I am leaving you my shalom,"
cuando Yeshua dice que yo estoy dejando mi shalom,
and my shalom I'm giving to you,
y mi shalom te estoy dando a ti,
he was saying a lot more than just this one little teeny weeny peace word.
Él está diciendo mucho más que esta palabra muy pequeña.
But if you've been misled by Satan,
pero si tú estabas siendo mal guiados por Satanás,
and thinking that these scriptures are not Jewish,
empezar que pensar que estas escrituras no eran judías.
And you don't have to start thinking like a Jew.
Y que no piensas que tiene que pensar como un judío.
Or you don't need the Old Testament anymore.
O que no necesitas el Antiguo Testamento ya.
Then you've lost the essence of the Bible.
Entonces ha perdido la esencia de la Biblia.
You've lost the power of His Word.
Ha perdido el poder de su palabra.
And pretty soon, if you don't plug up that hole,
y si no, arreglas ese hoyo,
if you don't plug up that hole in that boat,
ese hoyo en ese barco,
your life is going to sink to the bottom of the ocean.
Tu vida se va a hundir al final del océano.
Now look at verse 27 again.
Vamos a mirar el versículo 27 otra vez.
What I am leaving with you is shalom. I am giving you shalom. Giving you my shalom. I don't give it the way the world gives. Don't let yourselves be upset or frightened. Now let's read it a little differently.
Ahora vamos a leerlo diferente.
What I am leaving with you is completeness, soundness, welfare, peace, safety. I am giving you my welfare, health, prosperity, quiet, tranquility, contentment, friendship with God, especially my covenant relationship. I don't give it the way the world gives. Don't let yourselves be upset or frightened. It's a little bit different. Don't you think?
Es un poquito diferente, ¿no piensas?
Oh, we don't need those Jewish things anymore.
Oh, no necesitamos esas cosas judías ya.
So when Yeshua said this little phrase,
cuando Yeshua dijo esta frase muy pequeña,
to these Jewish guys,
a estos hombres judíos,
it meant a whole lot more.
Significaba mucho más.
It's sort of like me telling an Italian we're having spaghetti and sauce.
Es como diciéndole a un italiano que vamos a tener espagueti y salsa.
We're a Spanish congregation.
Oh, somos una congregación hispana.
We're having rice.
Vamos a tener arroz.
Okay? Now, the Peruvian rice, the Peruvians are going to say it's the best, right?
El peruano va a decir que su arroz es mejor, ¿no?
But my Mexicans are going to say,
no,
the Mexican rice.
El arroz mexicano es
the Puerto
mejor.
Ricans are just going to get into a fight.
Los puertorriqueños van a pelear.
You see how different rice could be for you?
¿Tú ves qué diferente puede ser el arroz para ti?
Now take that word, peace.
Ahora vamos a tomar esa palabra paz.
My peace I give you.
Mi paz te doy.
No, Yeshua didn't say that.
No, Yeshua no dijo eso.
Because he was talking to a bunch of Jews.
Porque él estaba hablando a unos judíos.
And we didn't eat rice, we had couscous.
Y nosotros no comíamos arroz, teníamos couscous.
And there was only one couscous in our land.
Y nada más había un couscous en nuestra
and
tierra.
And it's the best in all the world.
Y era el mejor de todo el mundo.
So when he said, my shalom I give to you,
entonces, cuando él dice, mi paz, mi shalom, yo te
he
doy
was
a
talking
ti.
To people who already understood what he was saying.
Él estaba hablando a personas que ya estaba entendiendo lo que él estaba diciendo.
They already understood the meaning of this very powerful word.
Ya entendían el poder de esta palabra tan que tenía tan significado.
It is our job in the end of days.
Es nuestro trabajo en el en los finales días.
To understand it.
Para entenderlo.
But why?
Pero ¿por qué?
If we want to see him more clearly,
si queremos verlo más claramente,
love him more dearly,
amarlo tan queridamente,
and follow him more nearly,
y seguirlo tan cercamente,
day by day,
día por día,
we need to leave the world,
tenemos que dejar el mundo,
and become a follower of Messiah.
Y hacernos un seguidor del Mesías.
We need to become part of his family spiritually.
Tenemos que ser parte de su familia espiritualmente.
So why would these Jewish men,
porque estos hombres judíos,
that Yeshua was speaking
que
to,
Yeshua le estaba hablando,
why would they understand what he was saying?
¿Por qué es que ellos estaban entendiendo lo que él estaba diciendo?
Well, one thing, they were all speaking Hebrew.
Una de las cosas, todos estaban hablando hebreo.
They were not speaking Aramaic.
No estaban hablando Aramaic.
They were speaking Hebrew.
Estaban hablando hebreo.
And we know this from the sign that was above Yeshua's head.
Y sabemos de el letrero que estaba arriba de la cabeza de Yeshua.
It was written in Hebrew,
hebreo,
Latin,
Latino,
and Greek.
Y griego.
And we know that it was Hebrew and not Aramaic.
Y sabemos que era hebreo y no Aramaic.
Because the Pharisees got all mad.
Porque los fariseos se enojaron.
Because when you take the first letter
porque
of what they wrote,
cuando tomas la primera letra de lo que escribieron,
of each word,
de cada palabra,
it said Yeshua Hanatzet Vaha Yehudi, Yud Hey Vav. Hey,
las letras,
Jehovah.
Yud Hey Vav Hey Jehovah.
That was written above his head.
Esto es lo que estaba escrito arriba de su cabeza.
And you need to understand that.
Y tienes que entender esto.
You need to come into his house.
Tienes que entrar en su casa espiritualmente.
So when Yeshua was speaking to his Talmudim in Hebrew,
cuando Yeshua le está hablando a sus discípulos en hebreo,
when he said, my shalom I give to you.
Cuando le dijo, mi shalom te doy a ti.
I give you my tranquility.
Te doy mi tranquilidad.
I give you my friendship.
Te doy mi amistad.
I give you my love.
Te doy mi amor.
I give you my blessings so that you would have family.
Te doy mis bendiciones para tener familia.
I give you prosperity.
Te doy prosperidad.
He wasn't just saying, I give you peace.
Él no nada más le estaba diciendo, te doy paz.
Oh, it was so nice to have a little peace.
Oh, estaba tan bueno de tener paz.
I was
paz.
Having so many problems with my wife this day.
Oh, yo tenía tantos problemas con mi esposa este día.
No, I give you my assuredness.
No, yo te doy mi seguridad.
I give you my friendship.
Te doy mi amistad.
How many people want the friendship of the Lord?
¿Cuántas personas quieren la amistad
so
del Señor?
If you want the shalom of the Lord,
si quieres el shalom del Señor,
please, please draw near to me.
Por favor, acércate a mí.
But it was even more of what he was saying.
Pero a más que estaba diciendo él.
Because there's something that we should do each and every day.
Porque es algo que debemos hacer cada día.
Turn to Numbers chapter 6.
Números capítulo 6, por favor.
Numbers chapter 6.
Números capítulo 6.
Bamidbar.
Números.
Numbers. Anybody getting anything so far?
¿Alguien está cogiendo algo? Amen.
To see thee more nearly, love thee more dearly, day by day. Well, Jews, we went to plays our entire life. But there was one high school on YouTube that did this in 2005, they were phenomenal.
Really?
Oh, I'll show it to you later. It was really spectacular.
Cool.
Zena High School. I don't know where Zena High School is.
Zena High School.
But they were, they did the play Godspell. Incredible. Incredible. High schoolers. They, that choir. Oh, it was awesome. Numbers chapter 6.
Números capítulo 6.
Verse 22 through to 27.
Versículos 22 hasta el 27.
Adonai said to Moshe, speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them that this is how you are to bless the people of Israel. You are to say to them, Yibarecha ka Adonai v'rishmerecha, Ya'e Adonai panav elecha v'kunecha, Yisa Adonai panav elecha v'yachem lacha shalom. May Adonai bless and keep you. May Adonai make his face shine on you and show you his favor. May Adonai lift his face towards you and give you shalom.
Shalom.
Verse 26, look closer.
Versículo 26, más cercamente, míralo.
Yisa Adonai panav elecha v'yasem lacha shalom. Everybody want to say that? Yisa.
Yisa.
Adonai.
Adonai.
Panav elecha.
Panav elecha.
V'yasem lacha shalom. May Adonai give you, give us his shalom.
Que Adonai nos dé su shalom.
What does that mean again?
¿Qué significa esto otra vez?
May Adonai lift his face towards you and give you completeness, soundness, welfare, peace, safety, welfare, health, prosperity, quiet, tranquility, contentment, friendship, and a covenant relationship.
Amen.
This is why those Talmudim, those disciples understood him.
Sorry, es por esto que los discípulos entendían todo esto.
Sorry, as you can see, I just love this. He wanted to give us so much.
Él quería darnos tanto.
He wanted to bless us so much.
Quería bendecirnos tanto.
But if you didn't understand, you know, you don't need those Jewish scriptures anymore.
Pero
we're
si
under
tú
grace.
Dices, no necesitamos esas escrituras judías porque estamos bajo gracia.
May Adonai lift up his face towards you and give you completeness.
Que Adonai levante su cara y mire donde ti te des completo.
Soundness.
Entero.
Welfare.
Bienestar.
Safety.
Seguridad.
Health.
Salud.
Prosperity.
Prosperidad.
Tranquility.
Tranquilidad.
Friendship.
Amistad.
A relationship with him.
Una relación con él.
And this is supposed to be for all the people of Israel.
Y esto es para todas las personas de Israel.
So whether you're naturally born,
si tú eres naturalmente nacido,
or whether you're engrafted in,
o si está injertido,
this is for all of us.
Esto es por todos nosotros.
You need to be part of his family.
Tienes que ser parte de su familia.
So when I, at the end of service, chant this blessing over the congregation.
Entonces cuando yo, cuando se acaba el servicio,
now
y
you
digo
will
esto,
truly understand what it is that is being said.
Ahora tú vas a entender lo que verdaderamente está siendo dicho.
It is vitally important for your heart.
Es muy importante por su corazón.
To take this in.
Para tomar esto y entrarlo.
To take this into your spirit.
Para entrarlo en su espíritu.
Because if we want to follow him more clearly.
Porque si queremos seguirlo más claramente.
To love him more dearly.
Quererlo más queridamente.
To follow him more nearly.
Y seguirlo más cercamente.
Day by day we need to draw closer to him.
Día por día tenemos que acercarnos más hacia él.
We need to get rid of the old chametz.
Tenemos que salirnos de la el antiguo levadura.
We need to get the new leavening.
Tenemos que entrar la nueva levadura.
We need to draw from heaven and come closer to him.
Tenemos que acercarnos de el cielo y hacia él.
To desire him more.
Desearlo él más.
Not to desire video games,
no desear juegos de video,
a new car,
un carro nuevo,
a new pair of shoes,
un zapato nuevo.
No, Jess doesn't buy new shoes.
No, I haven't. Promise.
We need to desire more spiritual things from him.
Tenemos que desear más cosas espirituales de él.
To get more things from above.
Para buscar cosas de hacia arriba.
Because Hasatan, Satan,
porque Satanás
will do whatever he can to change your mind.
Va a hacer lo que él quiera para cambiar tu mente.
Oh, I haven't bought new shoes in a long time.
Oh, no he comprado zapatos nuevos en un tiempo but largo.
The rabbi should look good.
Los rabinos debe de, el rabino debe de ser mirarse bueno.
I don't care what I look like.
Yo a mí no me importa lo que como yo me miro.
I care that the seats are filled.
Pero me importa si las sillas están
completas. I care that people were worshiping him today.
Me importa que las personas estaban adorándolo hoy.
My heart is saddened when I look outside.
Mi corazón está entristecido.
And I see everybody just shopping and doing things on his day.
Cuando mira las personas comprando y haciendo cosas en su día.
Because Satan says that you don't need any of this.
Porque Satanás está diciendo tú no necesitas esas cosas.
This is why we try to teach his word.
Por eso es que aquí tratamos de enseñar su palabra.
So that you will grow up in him.
Para que tú puedas crecer en él.
That you will no longer be babies on milk.
No ser bebés en la leche.
So that you will be able to get through the tougher things.
Para poder sobrepasar las cosas más duras.
So when the Lord throws a trial at you.
Para que cuando el Señor te tire una tribulación a ti.
When you want to choke your office mate.
Cuando tú quieres ahorcar tu colega del trabajo.
You are not in an office with a door.
Tú no estás en una oficina con una puerta.
Could you just be a little more quieter?
Tú puedes un poquito más callado.
I'm trying to concentrate on my work here.
Estoy tratando de concentrarme en mi trabajo.
I was sleeping.
Estaba durmiendo. Oh, no.
You need to draw closer to Adonai and his ways.
Tienes que acercarte más allá a Adonai.
So when those trials come,
para que cuando esas tribulaciones vengan,
Satan won't be able to trick you.
Satanás no pueda engañarte.
You will have that shalom.
Vas a tener ese shalom.
Turn to Luke chapter 10, please.
Lucas capítulo 10, por favor.
Luke chapter 10, please.
Lucas 10, por favor.
Anybody getting anything so far?
¿Todo el mundo está cogiendo algo?
You understand what the word shalom means
¿Está
now?
¿Está entendiendo lo que significa la palabra shalom?
When you say good morning, shalom aleichem.
Cuando tú dices buena mañana, dices shalom aleichem.
This, now you know what it means.
Ahora sabes lo que significa.
Or when you wish somebody a good Shabbos.
O cuando le dice a alguien buen sábado.
Good yont. Sorry. Doing my family now and doing yont if I'm doing yont. Doing Yiddish. Peace be with you.
Alechem
be with you. With you. Luke chapter 10, verse 1 through 12.
Lucas capítulo 10, 1 al 12.
After this, the Lord appointed 70 other Talmudim and sent them on ahead in pairs to every town and place where he himself was about to go. He said to them, "To be sure, there is a large harvest, but there are few workers. Therefore, plead with the Lord of the harvest that he speed workers out to gather in his harvest. Get going now, pay attention. I am sending you out like lambs among wolves. Don't carry a money belt or a pack, and don't stop to schmooze with people on the road. Whenever you enter a house, first say shalom to the household. If the seeker of shalom is there, your shalom will find its rest with him. And if there isn't, it will return to you. Staying at that same house, eating and drinking what they offer. For a worker deserves his wages. Don't move about from house to house. Whenever you come into a town where they make you welcome, eat what is put in front of you. Heal the sick there and tell them the kingdom of God is near you. But wherever you enter a town, they don't make you welcome. Go out into its street and say, even the dust of your town that sticks to your feet, we will wipe off as a sign against you. But understand this, the kingdom of God is near. I tell you, it will be more tolerable on the day of judgment for Sodom than for that town. Amen?
Amen.
Ooh, I thought this was the New Testament, the Testament of Grace.
Yo pensaba que este era el Nuevo Testamento de Gracia.
I guess Yeshua must have missed that one.
Entonces me imagino que Yeshua no vio esto.
Let's look closer at verse 1 now.
Vamos a mirar cercamente el versículo 1 ahora.
After this, the Lord appointed 70 other Talmudim disciples and sent them ahead in pairs to every town and place where he himself was about to go. Amen?
Amen.
I was wondering what the names of these 70 guys were.
Yo estaba pensando que era el nombre de estos 70 personas.
He sent 70 other disciples.
Él mandó 70 otros discípulos.
Why don't we know their names?
¿Por qué no sabemos sus nombres?
Then it must be even more special.
Debe de ser más especial.
For those who he discipled then for the next couple of years.
Esos que él estaba discipulando por estos próximos años.
Because those 70, we don't know who they were.
Porque estos 70, nosotros no sabemos quién son.
So they must not have done their job well.
Entonces no estaban haciendo su trabajo tan bueno.
Or we would have known their names.
O podemos saber sus nombres.
We need to get back.
Tenemos que volver.
In our lives.
En nuestras vidas.
And in this end of days.
Y en estos días finales.
To repairing the broken walls.
Para arreglar estas paredes rotas.
To building up Adonai's word throughout this country.
Construyendo la palabra de Adonai en todo este país.
Throughout this world.
En este mundo.
Throughout every nation.
En esta nación.
We need to say that yes, Torah is good.
Tenemos que decir sí, la Torah es buena.
We need to say that yes, these are the perfect teachings from above.
Sí, estas son las enseñanzas perfectas de arriba.
We need to say that yes, we still need to follow these ways.
Sí, tenemos que decir, tenemos que seguir estos caminos.
We need to be. We need to be like Nehemiah, but like Nehemiah, repairing Adonai's walls.
Tenemos que ser como Nehemías, que estaba reparando la pared de Adonai.
So that we don't get lost like those 70 people.
Para que nosotros no perdemos como estas 70 personas.
Let's look at verse 3 through 6 again.
Vamos a mirar versículos 3 al 6 otra vez.
Get going now, but pay attention. I am sending you out like lambs among wolves. Don't carry a money belt or a pack. And don't stop to schmooze with the people on the road. Whenever you enter a house, first say shalom to the people, to the household. If a seeker of shalom is there, your shalom will find its rest with him. And if there isn't, it will return to you. Amen?
Amen.
So here is Yeshua using this shalom word again.
Aquí está Yeshua usando esta palabra shalom otra vez.
So this could be a test.
Esto puede ser una prueba.
I come to Jefferson's house.
Yo vengo a la casa de Jefferson.
And I say shalom.
Y yo le digo shalom.
And he doesn't say shalom back.
Y él no me devuelve el shalom.
This may be a hint that he's not my brother.
Esto puede ser un indicio que él no es mi hermano.
But when I went over to Jefferson's house, I said shalom.
Pero cuando voy a la casa de Jefferson, le digo
shalom.
And what
did you reply? He's replied shalom back.
Y él dijo shalom, me devolvió el shalom.
Because he understood the ways of God.
Porque él entendió los caminos de Dios.
I said shalom, and I mean a covenant. Are you my covenant brother?
Cuando yo digo shalom, yo digo tú eres mi hermano de pacto.
When you say these things,
cuando dice estas cosas,
and the person looks like you like a deer in a headlight,
y la persona te mira así como un venado.
The lights are on, but nobody's home.
Las luces están encendidas, pero nadie está en la casa.
But if we are going to be bringers of the word.
Pero si vamos a traer la palabra,
we need to understand who we were talking to.
Tenemos que entender a quién le estamos hablando.
And that shalom will rest between those two people.
Y que shalom va a estar en estas dos personas.
And we'll be able to do things together.
Y que podemos hacer las cosas juntas.
It's like a good marriage.
Es como un buen matrimonio.
Kelly and I worked together hand in hand for the last 24 years.
Kelly y yo trabajamos juntos por los últimos 24 años.
And yes, there were some bumps along the way.
Y sí, había unas tribulaciones en el camino.
But because we have shalom of Adonai.
Pero porque tenemos shalom de Adonai.
And we have this covenant relationship with our Lord.
Y tenemos esta relación de pacto con nuestro Señor.
Then the bump did not become a major pothole.
Esto no se hizo un hoyo más grande.
We were able to get through that time.
Pudimos sobrepasar estos tiempos.
So when Yeshua says, my shalom I give to you.
Cuando Yeshua dice, mi shalom te doy a ti.
And when you're going into that house, you say shalom.
Y cuando tú vayas a entrar a esa casa, le dices shalom.
And those people don't return that.
Y esas personas no te devuelve eso.
You know to get on your armor.
Tú sabes que entonces te tienes que poner la arma.
You need to put on that helmet of salvation.
Tienes que poner esa casco, gracias, de salvación.
Casco?
Costco,
I like
not
Costco.
Costco.
Okay. If you want to see him more clearly,
si lo quieres ver más claramente,
you need to put the Costco on.
Tienes que poner el helmet.
You need to love him more dearly.
Tienes que quererlo más queridamente.
You need to follow him more nearly.
Seguirlo más cercamente.
Then that shalom will come when you're going out.
Y este shalom te va a volver cuando estás saliendo.
But if not,
pero si no,
then your ship's going to sink.
El barco se va a hundir.
Look at verse 5 again.
Vamos a mirar versículo 5 otra vez.
Whenever you enter a house, first say shalom to the household. Amen?
Amen.
But if that person doesn't speak the language,
si esa persona no habla el lenguaje,
sometimes you guys start speaking Spanish to me.
A veces ustedes me hablan español.
And you start speaking really fast.
Entonces empiezas a hablar muy rápido.
And I say, tranquilo.
Entonces yo te digo, careful.
Slow down.
Suave.
Suave, por favor.
Por favor.
Slow down, please. Because my Spanish ain't that good.
Porque mi español no es tan bueno.
But if you love the Lord,
pero si tú quieres el Señor,
you will love to learn His language.
Tú vas a querer aprender su lenguaje.
So that you can understand His Hebrew thought process.
Para que tú puedas entender el proceso de hebreo de él.
After we take our first steps of accepting Him,
después que nosotros tomamos esos pasos,
then we need to learn how to become a messianic follower.
Tenemos que aprender cómo hacernos un seguidor mesiánico.
Not a follower of Paul.
No un seguidor de Pablo.
I follow Yeshua.
Yo sigo a Yeshua.
Paul says he follows Yeshua.
Pablo dice que él sigue
Yeshua. Barnabas said he followed Yeshua.
Barnabas dice que él sigue Yeshua.
John said he followed Yeshua.
Juan dice que él sigue
Matthew
Yeshua.
Matthew followed Yeshua.
Mateo siguió a Yeshua.
So daggone it, I'm going to follow him too, Yeshua.
So yo también lo voy a seguir a Yeshua.
So we need to follow him.
Para nosotros poder seguirlo.
Turn to Acts chapter 2, please.
Vamos a ir a Hechos capítulo 2, por favor.
Acts chapter 2, please.
Hechos capítulo 2.
Acts chapter 2, Hechos, right?
Hechos, yes.
Hechos, sí, I'm getting it. Hechos versículo 2.
No,
capítulo 2, versículo 1.
Very good.
Acts chapter 2.
Hechos 2.
Go to the end of the Gospels and make a right.
Si vas al final de la Evangelia, hay una derecha.
Acts chapter 2. Anybody getting anything today?
¿Todo el mundo está consiguiendo algo hoy?
Only another 2.5 hours.
Nada más 2 horas y medias más.
You ready for another 2.5 hours?
Otra 2 horas y media.
No,
puedes pararte. Yeah.
All right, everybody got Acts chapter 2?
Todo el mundo tiene Hechos capítulo 2.
We're going to look at verse 1.
Versículo 1, por favor.
The festival of Shavuot arrived, and the believers all gathered together in one place. Amen?
Amen.
Now, it said in that translation, the one we're reading, the complete Jewish Bible.
Dice en la Biblia completa judía.
That the festival of Shavuot arrived.
Dice la fiesta de Shavuot.
But I'm going to read it now in the King James.
Pero lo voy a leer en el King James.
And when that day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all in one accord in one place. Amen?
Amen.
Oh, amen. Amen.
Amen.
See, if you are a person who calls Yeshua your Savior,
si tú eres una persona que llama Yeshua como tu Salvador,
then if you're reading your Bible,
si está leyendo su Biblia,
and you see the word Pentecost,
y ves la palabra Pentecostés,
and you've read the entire Old Testament,
y ha leído el Antiguo Testamento completo,
and that word did not appear once,
y esa palabra no apareció ni una vez,
you might ask this question.
Tú puedes hacer esta pregunta.
When is Pentecost?
¿Cuándo es Pentecostés?
And why is that there?
¿Y por qué esto está aquí?
Why is that day there?
¿Por qué ese día está aquí?
And when did Yeshua celebrate Pentecost?
¿Y cuándo fue que Yeshua celebró Pentecostés?
Look at verse 1 again.
Vamos a ver el versículo 1 otra vez.
And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. Amen?
Amen.
So, how am I going to be in one accord with Yeshua?
¿Cómo yo voy a estar unido con Yeshua?
Like these first followers of Messiah.
Como estos primeros seguidores del Mesías.
Well, first of all, I'm not going to drive a Honda.
Primero
no, that is an accord. So, how am I going to be one echad with Messiah?
¿Cómo voy a estar unido uno con el Mesías?
How am I going to be like one of these first believers?
¿Cómo yo voy a ser como estos primeros creyentes?
Look at verse 1 again.
Vamos a mirar el versículo 1 otra vez.
The festival of Shavuot arrived and the believers all gathered together in one place. Amen?
Amen.
So you see, when you get a proper translation,
¿ves cuando consigues una traducción apropiada?
And a proper understanding,
y un entendimiento apropiado,
you will follow the Lord in a proper manner.
Vas a seguir al Señor en una manera apropiada.
One, you will know when that day is.
Primero, vas a saber cuándo es este día.
Two, you will understand why they were in one accord.
Dos, vas a entender por qué estaban unidos.
Right? It,
¿verdad?
If the church is celebrating Pentecost,
si la iglesia está celebrando Pentecostés,
but Yeshua is following Shavuot,
pero Yeshua está celebrando Shavuot.
Okay, this year they actually end up on the same day.
Bueno, este año los dos se unen en el mismo día.
But 2 years ago they were this far apart.
Pero dos años atrás estaban así de lejos.
They were like a month apart.
Eran como un mes separado.
So I'm going to follow Yeshua.
Entonces voy a seguir a Yeshua.
I'm going to worship on his days.
Voy a adorar en su día.
Because I want to be there with in one accord with him.
Porque yo quiero estar unido con él.
3 things I pray.
Tres cosas que oro.
To see him more clearly.
Verlo más claramente.
Love him more dearly.
Quererlo más queridamente.
Follow him more nearly.
Seguirlo más cercamente.
Day by day.
Día por día.
Now you don't have to do everything at once.
No tienes que hacer todo en una vez.
But you draw closer each and every day.
Pero cada día te acercas más.
And when you realize you are doing something that is not of Adonai,
y cuando realizas que estás haciendo las cosas que no son de Adonai,
you must think, should I be doing it?
Tienes que pensar, ¿debo de estar haciendo esto?
Let's look at 2 John chapter 1, please.
Vamos a 2 de Juan capítulo 1.
2 John chapter 1, please.
2 de Juan capítulo 1, por favor.
Coming to the home stretch.
Casi, casi.
2 John chapter 1, please.
Segundo de Juan, capítulo 1, por favor.
2 John chapter 1, please.
Segundo de Juan, capítulo 1.
Would you like them?
Yes. Thank you.
We're going to read verse 1 through 11.
Vamos a leer versículo 1 hasta el 11.
From the elder to the chosen lady and her children, whom I love in truth, and not only I, but also all who have come to know the truth, because the truth which remains united with us and will be with us forever. Grace, mercy, and there's that word again, shalom, will be with us from God the Father and from Yeshua the Messiah, the Son of the Father, in truth and love. I was very happy when I found some of your children living in truth, just as the Father commanded us. And now, dear lady, I am requesting that we love one another, not as if there were a new command I am writing you, for it is the one which we have had from the beginning. Moreover, love is this, that we should live according to his commands. Oh my goodness. This is the command, as you people have heard from the beginning. Live by it. For many deceivers have gone out into the world, people who do not acknowledge Yeshua the Messiah's coming as human beings. Such a person is a deceiver and an anti-Messiah. Watch yourselves so that you won't lose what you have worked for, but will receive your full reward. Everyone who goes ahead and does not remain true to what Messiah has taught does not have God. Those who remain true to his teaching have both the Father and the Son. If someone comes to you and does not bring this teaching, don't welcome him into your home. Don't even say shalom to him. For the person who says shalom to him shares in his evil deeds. Amen?
Amen.
Ooh, that's some pretty powerful words there.
Estos son palabras muy poderosas ahí.
And this is from one of the disciples.
Y esto es de uno de los discípulos.
Let's take a closer look at 10 and 11.
Vamos a mirar cercamente el versículo 10 y 11.
If someone comes to you and does not bring this teaching, don't welcome him into your home. Don't even say shalom to him, for the person who says shalom to him shares in his evil deeds. Amen?
Amen.
Ooh, that's some heavy words from John.
Esos son palabras fuertes de Juan.
Now remember, this was all written in Hebrew at first.
Acuérdate, esto todo estaba escrito en hebreo primero.
Now these men were followers of Torah.
Estos hombres eran seguidores de la Torah.
Here, Yochanan said, if somebody comes to you,
aquí Yochanan está diciendo, Juan, está says, diciendo si alguien te viene a ti.
Let's celebrate Mother's Day.
Y dice, vamos a celebrar el Día de las
Everybody,
Madres.
Every woman should get a rose here today.
Todo el mundo debe de conseguir una rosa aquí hoy en día.
I would say, oh, that's very beautiful.
Oh, esto es muy bonito.
But can you show me that here in the word of truth?
Pero puede enseñarme esto en la palabra de verdad?
Can you show me Yeshua celebrating one Mother's Day?
Puede enseñarme un lugar donde Yeshua estaba celebrando un día de las madres?
Now Miriam's a pretty nice lady.
Miriam es una mujer muy nice.
She gave Trevor. Her son to us so that we could have life.
Ella nos dio su hijo para que nosotros podamos tener vida.
She gave everything for us.
Ella nos dio todo para nosotros.
But Yeshua never said to worship Mary.
Pero Yeshua nunca dijo que adores a Miriam.
He said, worship the Father.
Dijo que adore el Padre.
Worship the Son.
Adore el Hijo.
He said, be with them.
Dice que esté con ellos.
But if we share with these evil, misguided deeds,
pero si nosotros estamos compartiendo con estas cosas maldiciosas,
oh, it's just Mother's Day.
No, nada más Día de las Madres.
What are you making such a big deal about it?
¿Por qué está haciendo un gran, una gran escándalo?
I couldn't care less.
No, a mí no me importara.
But he does.
Pero él sí.
Because he gave you the days he wanted you to celebrate.
Porque él te dio esos días que él quería que tú celebraras.
Oh, that sounds pretty harsh.
Oh, esto suena un poquito duro.
He's an unforgiving God.
Oh, él es un Dios que no perdona.
He's got all those rules.
Él tiene tantas reglas.
Yeah, he was also the one that said, let there be light.
Sí, él también fue el que dijo que haya luz.
And there was light.
Y había luz.
He's the guy that winds up the world every day.
Es el hombre que puede hacer que el mundo se voltee.
He's the one that keeps all the planets going in the right order.
Él es el que hace que los planetas se pongan en la orden apropiada.
Do you understand what we're on a ball?
¿Entiendes que nosotros estamos que en una bola?
You're really standing to the side.
En verdad está parado al lado.
And the water's not coming off.
Y el agua no está cayendo, saliéndose.
Can somebody else make gravity?
¿Alguien puede hacer la gravedad?
They go to the moon and they're jumping really high.
Ellos van a la luna y están brincando.
They're on a space shuttle and they're floating away. If they're not tied, they would float away.
Están en el espacio y si no estaban amarrados se pueden ir.
So when Adonai says, follow my days,
so Adonai, cuando él dice que sigue mis días,
these are not the 10 recommendations.
No son las 10 recomendaciones.
These are the 10 teachings from the God of heaven.
Son las 10 enseñanzas del Dios del cielo.
So if this Talmud is telling you,
si este discípulo te está diciendo,
don't even share with those people with that.
Que no comparte con estas personas.
And what did Franklin Graham say?
¿Qué dijo Franklin Graham?
Oh, we're not going to be even able to pray outside in the street.
Oh, ni vamos a poder orar en el público, en la calle.
Well, somebody tells me I can't pray.
Si alguien me dice que yo no puedo orar.
The shofar is going to end up somewhere.
El shofar va a estar en un lugar.
Because this Jew will not stand down from my God's Torah.
Porque este judío no se va a apartar de la Torah de Dios.
Because we need to stand in the gap for this world.
Porque nosotros tenemos que estar parado en la brecha para este mundo.
We need to stand on the watchtower.
Tenemos que pararnos en la torre de vigilancia.
We need to understand that Adonai gives us power.
Tenemos que entender que Adonai nos da el poder.
Look at verse 9 again, please.
Vamos a mirar el versículo 9 otra vez, por favor.
Everyone who goes ahead and does not remain true to what Messiah has taught does not have God. Those who remain true to his teachings have both the Father and the Son. Amen?
Amen.
So where did Messiah say to change the Sabbath?
¿Dónde fue que el Mesías dijo que cambie el sábado?
Did he ever said to change the Sabbath?
¿Él dijo que lo cambiara?
Did Messiah ever put a Christmas tree up?
¿Mesías puso un arbolito de Navidad?
Did the Messiah ever eat one ham sandwich?
¿Tú has visto el Mesías comer un emparedado de
Taylor ham and cheese on a hard roll with mayonnaise?
Un emparedado de jamón con mayonnaise.
Bacon.
Con tocineta.
Okay, so if he didn't do it,
si él no lo hizo,
then you need to stay true to his teachings.
Entonces te tienes que mantener verdadero a sus enseñanzas.
Yeshua said he and the Father are one.
Yeshua dijo que él y el Padre son uno.
Yeshua said how to follow the way, the truth, and his way of life.
Yeshua dijo que siga el camino, la verdad y la vida.
So that we will remain true to our marriage to God.
Para que seamos verdaderos a nuestro matrimonio con Dios.
How many extra wives do you have?
¿Cuántas esposas
Don't
extra
answer
tienen?
That.
No conteste.
How many extra wives do you have?
¿Cuánta?
Does any man here have any extra wives?
Algunos hombres aquí tienen esposas adicionales.
Because we need to be true to our marriage.
Porque tenemos que ser verdaderos
one
a nuestro
man,
matrimonio. Un hombre,
one woman,
una mujer.
Forever.
Para siempre.
What God has joined together, man shall not break apart.
Lo que Dios ha unido, el hombre no va a poder apartar.
We need to follow the King of the Jews.
Tenemos que seguir el Rey de los Judíos.
We need to follow the way, the truth, and His way of life.
El camino, la verdad y la vida.
Turn to our final scripture,
Psalm
119.
Salmo 119.
We're going to read all of it.
No,
we're just going to read hey.
No. Vamos a leer, hey.
Psalm Tehillim 119 verse 33.
Salmo 119 versículo 33.
And we're only going to read 3 verses.
Y nada más 3 versículos.
33 through 35.
33 hasta el 35.
Tehillim 119.
Salmo 119.
We're going to read hey.
Hey.
Everybody got it?
¿Todo el mundo lo tiene? Salmo 119 versículo 33.
Through 38.
Hasta el 35.
Teach me, Adonai, the way of your laws. Keeping them will be its own reward for me. Give me understanding, then I will keep your Torah. I will observe it with all my heart. Guide me on the path of your mitzvot, for I take pleasure in it. Amen.
Amen.
Yeshua said, I am the way.
Yeshua dijo que él es el camino.
Look at verse 1. Verse 33, sorry.
33.
Teach me, Adonai, the way of your laws. Amen.
Amen.
So Yeshua said, I am the way.
Yeshua dijo, yo soy el camino.
He is the writer of the Old Testament.
Él es que escribió el Antiguo Testamento.
So we need to follow the Tanakh.
Entonces tenemos que seguir el Antiguo
so
Testamento.
When Yeshua said, I and the Father are one.
Cuando Yeshua dijo que yo y el Padre somos
we
uno.
We should take pleasure in it.
Tenemos de tomar placer en esto.
Look at verse 35, please.
Vamos a mirar el versículo 35, por favor.
Guide me on the path of your mitzvot, your commandments, for I take pleasure in it. Amen?
Amen.
I take pleasure in Yeshua's commandments.
Tomo placer en los mandamientos de Yeshua.
Because these are the teachings from above.
Porque estas son las enseñanzas de arriba.
This is why we need to read the scriptures.
Por eso es que tenemos que leer las escrituras.
With a heart of repentance.
Con un corazón de arrepentimiento.
This is why we need to read the scriptures.
Por eso es que tenemos que leer las escrituras.
As one who no longer wants to be deceived by the devil.
Como uno no, que no quiere ser decepcionado por el Satanás.
This is why it takes a while to become truly His.
Por eso es que toma un poquito de tiempo para ser verdaderamente
one step,
de él. Un paso.
Day by day.
Día por día.
Look at verse 34.
Vamos a mirar versículo 34.
Give me understanding, then I will keep your Torah. I will observe it with all my heart. Amen.
Amen.
Day by day.
Día por día.
Day by day.
Día por día.
Oh, dear Lord.
Oh, querido Señor.
Three things I pray.
Tres cosas oro.
To see thee more clearly.
Para verte más claramente.
Now that I know what shalom means.
Ahora que sé lo que significa shalom.
To love thee more dearly.
Para quererte más queridamente.
To understand that it is not Pentecost, but Shavuot.
Para entender que no es Pentecostés, pero es Shavuot.
To follow thee more nearly.
Para seguirte más cercamente.
And to walk in your ways in my heart and in my mind.
Y caminar en sus caminos con mi corazón y mi mente.
Day by day.
Día por día.
This is the prayer for the people of Israel.
Esta es la oración para el pueblo de Israel.
Yivarecha Adonai v'rishmerecha.
Que Adonai te bendiga y te mantenga.
Three things I pray.
Tres cosas oro.
Ya'eh Adonai panav aleicha v'ichunecha.
Que Adonai enseñe su cara a ti y te enseñe su favor.
Three things I pray.
Tres cosas yo oro.
Yisa Adonai panav aleicha v'yachem lecha shalom.
Que Adonai levante su cara hacia ti y te dé paz.
Three things I pray.
Tres cosas oro.
In this way you are to put my name on the people of Israel so that I will bless them.
Para que yo pueda bendecirlo y estas cosas tú pondrás en el nombre para la gente de Israel.
May the blessing of shalom be on each one of you.
Que la bendición
Amen.
De Shalom esté en cada uno
Amen.
De ustedes.
Amen. Amen. Why don't we just bow our hearts for one moment.
Vamos a bajar nuestros corazones por un momento.
Thank you for your word of Shalom, Lord.
Gracias por tu palabra de Shalom, Señor.
Three things I pray.
Tres cosas lloro.
That you would draw thousands to you this day.
Que acercarías miles a ti este día.
That they would love your Torah.
Que ellos querían tu Torah.
That they would be awoken to your ways.
Que se despertarían a sus caminos.
And that they would leave the world for your ways.
Y dejar al mundo para tu camino.
These things are not too hard.
Estas cosas no son muy duras.
If you're out there.
Si estás allá afuera.
And you want to have everlasting life.
Y quiere tener vida eternamente.
If you want to have shalom that passes all understanding.
Si quieres tener shalom que pasa todo entendimiento.
Yeshua is offering his life for yours.
Yeshua está ofreciendo su vida para la tuya.
He is the Messiah.
Él es el Mesías.
And it was written about in 400 places in the Old Testament.
Y estaba escrito en 400 lugares en el Antiguo Testamento.
He came to give you life.
Él vino para darte a ti vida.
So that you could come live in his house.
Para que tú puedas vivir en su casa.
And there is nothing you've done that he won't forgive.
Y no hay nada que tú has hecho que él no puede perdonar.
I'm going to lead in a prayer.
Yo voy a guiar en una oración.
And if you say this prayer for the first time.
Y si tú dices esta oración por la primera vez.
And you mean it in your heart.
Y tú lo añeles en tu corazón.
Then you will be truly his.
Entonces vas a ser verdaderamente de él.
Say Yeshua.
Di Yeshua.
I ask your forgiveness.
Pido tu perdón.
I didn't know how to hear you.
Yo no sabía cómo escucharte.
But I'm listening now.
Pero estoy escuchando ahora.
I ask for your forgiveness on my life.
Estoy preguntando por tu perdón en mi vida.
Please wash me.
Por favor, lávame.
Clean me.
Límpiame.
Make me something new.
Hágame algo nuevo.
That I may have the shalom that comes from you.
Para que yo pueda tener el shalom que viene de ti.
If you've done that for the first time.
Si tú has hecho esto por la primera vez.
Then you're born again.
Tú eres nacido de nuevo.
But Yeshua said.
Pero Yeshua dijo.
That you have to profess him before man. So that he can profess you before his father in heaven.
Que tú tienes que profesarle adelante de los hombres. Para que él te pueda profesar delante de su padre en el cielo.
If you've done that for the first time.
Si tú has hecho esto por la primera vez.
Just lift up your hand so we can pray with you.
Levante su mano para orar contigo.
If you're hearing this on television or on the internet.
Si está escuchando esto en la televisión o el radio.
Just let us know.
Déjanos saber.
So that we can pray with you.
Para que podamos orar contigo.
In your blessed name I pray, Yeshua.
En el nombre bendecido de Yeshua.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
The Remnant's Call is a message from Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation in Fairview, New Jersey, USA. Beth Goyim is located right outside of New York City. Beth Goyim is a congregation where Jew and Gentile worship together as one people, following the Route 66 King's Highway, Genesis to Revelation, the only perfect word of Adonai. For more information on this end time ministry and how you can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God, call 973-338-7800 or check out our website, BethGoyim.org or HouseOfTheNations.org. Be with us live on the Lord's Day, Shabbat, 11 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, and live for Bible study, Tuesday, 7 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Click on the On Air button. It is that simple. Remember, BethGoyim.org or HouseOfTheNations.org. 973-338-7800.
If you have not taken your first steps to be born again, just ask God's help. Remember, it's His loving grace that has come to find you. No one is worthy or able to reach God, but God can reach us. And He's reaching out to you now. Just open your heart and let Him in. His arms are open, and the blessing of salvation and eternal life are waiting for you. Don't let it wait any longer.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift His face and shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you His shalom.
The ancient Hebrew scripture foretold of the Anointed One, the Melech Yisrael, King of Israel, the Sar Shalom, Prince of Peace. Now, 2,000 years after the destruction of the Holy Temple in Israel, Jewish believers are once again telling Jew and Gentile about the Jewish Messiah, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus. Come out to Beth Goyim, House of the Nations, where Jew and Gentile worship Yeshua as one people. So it was in the beginning, so too shall it be in the end of days. Come out every Shabbat, Saturday, the Lord's Day, at 11 a.m. for Messianic worship and the Word from a truly biblical perspective. Once again, thanks again for tuning in to the Remnant's Call. In the name above any and all other names, Yeshua HaMashiach. Shalom.